This tutorial is going to cover how to do a binomial test on R. So a binomial test compares a sample proportion based on binary groups to a presumed population value. To do a binomial test on R, you can use the following function, where x is the number of successes, n is the number of trials, and p is the probability of success on a given trial. You can do a binomial test for two-tailed and one-tailed hypotheses, and in this tutorial we will cover both. An example of a two-tailed test is when you want to determine whether or not a dice lands on the number 5 during 1 out of 6 rolls. You roll the dice 30 times and it lands on a 5 a total of 18 times. To perform the binomial test, you can use the binom.test function to determine if the dice is expected to land on a 5 during 1 out of 6 of the rolls. So here is the code of how to run this binomial test. And remember the syntax from the slide before. So the first number is the number of successes we had, so 18. The second number is the number of trials, so how many times we rolled the dice, so that's 30. And finally, the last number is the probability of success, which is 1 out of 6. And here are the results. As you can see, the p-value is less than 0.05, so we can reject the null hypothesis and conclude that there is evidence to say that the dice does not land on the number 5 during 1 out of 6 of the rolls. So now we're going to move on to one-tailed tests. An example of a left-tailed test would be whether you wanted to determine whether or not a coin is less likely to land on a heads compared to tails. To do this, you flip the coin 50 times and find that it lands on a heads just 18 times. You can perform a binomial test to determine if the coin is actually less likely to land on heads compared to tails. To do this, you can use the code below, which is in the same format as the previous example. But for a left-tailed test, you need to specify that alternative equals less. And here are the results. As you can see, the p-value is less than 0.05, so we can reject the null hypothesis. So there is evidence to say that the coin is less likely to land on heads compared to tails. And finally, here is an example of a right-tailed test. So for example, if a shop makes an app with 70% effectiveness, then they implement a new system that they hope will improve the rate of effectiveness. So after they did this, they randomly selected 40 apps made recently and found that 35 of them are effective. So now you can perform a binomial test to determine if the new system leads to higher effectiveness or not. So again, the code is in the same format as both of the previous examples, but this time for a right-tailed test, you need to specify alternative equals greater. And here are the results. As you can see, the p-value is less than 0.05. So we can reject the null hypothesis and conclude that the new system produces effective apps at a higher rate than 70%. And here is a recap of the different codes for the binomial tests, which you can edit and use with your own examples.